nearly the end. This is another opal, and this is Mexican fire opal, which is a clear orange jelly. And it's very, this is this, I've just found this pair, these two pieces, and I've just done, this is my dim sum collection, because it's wrapped, and it's little pieces made from heart, which is what dim sum is. And it was a girl with very dark hair, and she said, I just want something completely different, no one has, and I want some orange earrings. And they really do have like a fire inside, and that's how fire opal grows. So that is Mexican fire opal. This is Peruvian pink opal, and there's a pair of earrings here, there. That's pink opal. So that's also dense. They're all slightly different compositions. Okay, so in the last 10 years, a brand new opal deposit was discovered in Ethiopia, and it's called the Ethiopian Wello opal. Nothing like the Lightning Ridge, nothing like Australian opal. It's beautifully clear. In the beginning, there were very big pieces. Now, as with anything, it's over mining, so you can't find so many. It has a different structure to Australian opal, because Australian opal is formed from water seeping through sandstone. This is volcanic activity. So this is created by heat and volcanoes. So it has a different structure. So it's been used in jewellery for 10 years. The Australians will say, well, ours has been 100 years and we know it's stable. The Ethiopian Wello, is it stable or not? But it seems to be that it is, and you can use it for very beautiful jewellery. This is just a really lovely poem, and I think this is the end. And let's see. Oh, yes, it's me, so it is the end. And I'll leave you to read it, but basically, if you can see it, come up. Do you want me to?
Yes, please.
Yeah. Are you sure?
Yes.
Hang on. So for me, as everybody knows, Elise and I are complete jewellery passionate. Yeah. And this for me is the meaning of jewellery. It's not greed and avarice. It's memories, beauty, and memories. This is all about my grandmother's opal, and this person says, nowadays I can find no picture of her. I lost the only photograph I had moving house. Nothing else came to me. So all I keep now is this opulent bead. Milky violet, craggy, sugar white, and crumpled gold leaf fused into the one hurtfully alluring crystal depth of opal, her favorite stone, which, like a scrying globe, entraps the eye. Though I should need more than a jeweler's glass to see what figures might floor the blue mist or walk unscathed out of that golden furnace, distant and enigmatic, bright and small as now my memories of her. Some stories and nonsense rhymes she riddled me out of her childhood, odd scents she used, her sharp, affectionate gaze, skirts I buried my face in, and the love which, like an animal, I could discern, inhabit, like warmth, but never comprehend, or so young I was, return. So here it is, my grandmother's opal, centerpiece of a necklace broken and strewn who now knows where. And of no use to me. It's too large for a ring, too splendid to cut down. Message I can't read, riches not mine to spend or give, unexplained trust I hold. I keep it, but where shall I set it? This one spark saved from the fiery heart of a lost world. And that to me encapsulates jewelry. And it doesn't really matter how grand, how expensive, how special. If that was your mother's, your grandmother's, your aunt's, your best friend's, that is a treasure. And this opal bead is the only thing that she has left of her dear grandmother. Mm-hmm. So for me, that's the power of jewellery. And yeah. So thank you.